रघुपति राघव राजा पतित पावन सीता
Chancellor, Symbiosis International University, Founder, Director and President, Symbiosis International Education Center, Padma Bhushan, Dr. S.P. Majumdar, to come and share his feelings with you. Sir.
Prakash sir, Devgan, and my student friends, I am extremely happy that Prakash sir has chosen Symbiosis International University campus to interact with young minds and ignite those minds. A professor at Harvard University, Professor Nye, proposed the concept of soft power, and I believe, Zaji, that a good picture, a good movie, is a soft power for our country, not only for our country to go abroad, but even to inspire young minds. Ultimately, if you see Mahatma Gandhi, if you see Anna Hazare, if you see Vivekananda, you will realize that the power of one man ultimately counts. I wish you all the best and thank you once again for choosing Symbiosis International University campus. Wish you all the best, my young friends.
May I now request the Acting Vice Chancellor, Symbiosis International University and Principal Director, Symbiosis International Educational Center, Dr. Vidya Yeravadkar, to come and share her feelings with you.
Thanks, Anupam. I know all of you have gathered here to listen to the three stalwarts, but Prakash Jhaji, I want to say this again and again and every time that you come to this campus, that please come and teach at this campus of what you actually do in your films, because his films are all with great themes. And I watched Satyagraha, and you know, when I watched it, I watched the 10:45 show, though it got over almost at 1:30, I messaged Amitabh Bachchan ji and told him that all that you have shown in Satyagraha is all that we encounter, especially me, when I go to the government offices to get things done for Symbiosis. Let me just tell you, but you know, my father always says, Dr. Muzumdar always says that, you know, honesty finally counts as long as you can sleep on a soft pillow every night. So I think this is Satyagraha, and the themes that Prakash Jhaji uses for all his films are some, you know, has some message to pass on to the young crowd. And I wish and hope that all of you, I'm sure you have seen the film, but for those who haven't, please go and see the film, because it's something that is what we at Symbiosis live with the same values and principles that are shown by you, sir, in the film. Thank you very much, and I would request Dr. Muzumdar, sir, to felicitate you, and then we will go into the audience.
Jha and Mr. Harshan have been here before, but I guess maybe for Mr. Devgan this is the first visit. And just to kickstart this conversation, here's another socio-political powerful story, again from the same camp, and we've seen this happening in the past 3 decades, that every time Mr. Jha makes a film, right from the 1984 National Award winning Damul till Satyagraha, there is something to think about, something that you take home after having left the theatre. And here comes another one, and as he describes it, he calls it a dialogue with the youth, and here's an extension to that. So let's have an actual dialogue with the youth. I was just wondering that, considering the fact that this has one of the best openings out of your films, so does it feel satisfactory by the end of the day that your labor of love has been accepted by so many people, or do you expect this film to do more than that?
Well, I think I'm always stating the truth if I didn't accept the fact that there is no end to expectation. But yes, we are extremely happy that the hard work all my principal characters, subsidiary characters, technicians, co-writers, everybody, all of us, we believed in the story. We worked very hard for it, and we put up a film which generally is not considered to be a commercial film as far as our Mumbai film industry is concerned. But we have faith that told in a very engaging manner and told very honestly, if we can, you know, even say difficult things or take up issues which are not generally spoken about in films, we could succeed. So the challenge is to use the commercial popular drama and to say what thing, you know, is in terms of analytical social movements, the way the society is moving. I mean, we were greatly influenced by the way the young India is growing, the new India is emerging, and this is a very powerful India because it is almost 65% of our population. And this India, the young India, is often connecting, the voices are multiplying, and they are expressing themselves out there on the streets, on their internet, and it is becoming a voice which has to be recognized, which has to be listened to, and which has to be acted upon. So I am extremely happy the way the film has opened. We are, you know, in a celebratory mood. But at the same time, we thought it probably is a good time to discuss the film. We could have come before the release of the film, but we thought that we'll come after the release of the film, and at least some of you have seen the film. How many of you have seen the film so far? Well, we could do very well with all the rest of you seeing the film, right? I I'm sure that you will like. Do you plan to see it? How many of you do plan to see it? Oh, super. Well, thank you very much. And to answer your question, yes, we are extremely happy for dwelling for more.
Also, in the recent past, especially the youth of the country has experienced a social movement like never before in their lives. This was the Anna Hazare campaign. And we do see a lot of parallels in the film with Anna Hazare's image and Arvind Kejriwal's image, the launch of the AAP. Though I'm aware that you have categorically denied but wasn't there any inspiration from the movement and the plethora of questions that it threw up?
Well, Mr. Arvind Kejriwal and his team saw the film first day, first show in Delhi, and they themselves admitted that the film is not the story of Anna Hazare. When you say inspired from Anna Hazare's movement, yes, because Anna Hazare's movement was against corruption, India against corruption, they moved it, and it was the first time, I think, that young people, young India and the middle class, they rallied together, because they were all suddenly possessed by this demonic social ill, which is called corruption. We are all facing it every single day. In fact, we have almost become used to it. It's become like the DNA of Indian society. I mean, I don't think corruption is only at the top, it's there at the bottom, in the middle, inside the corners, in the holes, everywhere. And to root it out, eventually, it will take a great effort, it will take a great learning, training, education, leveling of the society. Point of time, I don't think we can get to that discussion. But to answer your question, sir, the greatest inspiration for this film was Bapu, Mahatma Gandhi. Because he is the one who began, who coined the word Satyagraha, who devised the means to protest through non-violent methods. And coincidentally, he started it in my district, Champara, in Bihar, where he went to protest against the Indigo plant business. He was, Anna Hazareji was also influenced by Gandhiji, Jayaprakash Narayan was also influenced, and generations in this country have been influenced by him. I still think Anna Hazare's movement would have succeeded if Bapu was there. The reason it failed, that it was not ideologically driven. The reason it failed, because it was not politically strategized. We have a democracy in this country. And you cannot work out anything in this country in any autocratic manner, because we have to work within the realm of democracy. So eventually, my film also, as you say, Maro, the main character, realizes and tells Arjun that we will have to fight not from outside but by getting inside with them. Because unless and until we become politically engaged, politically engaged doesn't mean that you have to stand in elections. You have to. By becoming politically engaged means you have to become politically aware. You should know who is your leader, who you should vote, who you should place. And anything that happens in the country, you should be able to react with it politically. And whatever happened in last winter at India Gate, when thousands of children died with the cold, they came and they pressed it. and they stood the water cannons and Lathis, police Lathis, and yet they stood their ground and they continued to protest and they made the sovereign realize that they have to come up with a song for the same leader. That was a huge, massive political statement, but it was just still a baby step. I personally feel that young India, the day it engages itself politically, the day it begins to decide who is going to rule, the day it begins to decide who are the right people up there, there will be a sea change in this country.
So I just wanted to shift to a little cinematic, which is though I want to come back to you about that influence on Gandhi, because I thought the use of the bhajan was very, very powerful when it was done. If Mr. Devkan, I could ask you, this is a kind of a performance which by now we expect you to do. We thought it was a role tailor-made for you. So was it easier to do this, or is it just as difficult every time? See that for ourselves. There's just one small piece I noticed somewhere which said that you were still wearing your wedding ring. No, in the sense that because your character in the film was not married till that point of time. Okay, I mean, fair enough. Mr. Rampal, no. A similar question, not the ring one, though I'll come back to that as well. This is not a kind of a performance that we generally associate you. Of course, you had a rustic bent in Rajneeti as well, and that was also pulled off with aplomb. But so the question is, what kind of preparation do you do when you're not playing something which is up your alley?
Something new. And I think the most important thing of art